EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Dallas Cowboys. Get strapped in. It's just about time to get the party started. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. And Prescott to the air. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, 76 yards. And the Cowboys will jump on top of the game's first score here this afternoon. Let's make no bones about it. On paper, they're the better team. They're at home. That's a strong opening drive.
And just think how many times we've seen this type of a matchup. Just what you said, better team at home should steamroll them. And we've seen it go the other way. Sometimes, though, they buy into it and understand, we are the better team. Let's go out and prove it right now.
And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack, and they fail on the try for two. So they went for two and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Now Herbert to start the drive, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
So that'll be no better than an incompletion. And now third down and 6 to go.
That's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people, but you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line.
From the 46, here's 2nd and 3.
Herbert once more. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 7 yards there and a first down. couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time, that's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. And that one will go for 13 yards on the keeper at a first down.
Pretty ideal right there. Keep it yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I can get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, or probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man. Don't do that.
And a throw right sideline is complete. Touchdown, Bears.
Jarnell Mooney,
33 yards.
And the Bears are an extra point away from taking the lead. Bears offense staying put. Justin Fields always a threat to run. They'll go for two here.
They motion the running back out left.
Fields trying to throw for it.
That's caught. And he is not going to find the end zone. He stopped up short. And this remains a 6-6 game. So back even at six apiece as the kick's away.
But no run back here. Fair catch. And this will come out to the 25.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Prescott on first down.
A short one there, taken in by Ferguson.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards right off the bat with a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice
pressure. And he's taken down. A Bear sack.
Second and 12, operating from the 39.
Play fake. Here's Prescott.
A short one there, taken in by Ferguson.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Trying to run forward, Pollard. And he will not only not get the yard he needed, he goes the wrong direction. All tied up, 6-6, our score after one. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they've got it with a fourth down coming up.
Hey,
They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10. Off the play fake, Prescott. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Play action now. Prescott under pressure, and they got to him again. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Looking to throw. Prescott
swinging this out for Pollard.
And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a fourth and long.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Now look at this, fourth and 12, and they're going to line up to go for it. Prescott from the gun. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
And this is going to be recovered by a member of the offense, but whistles come in. Remember, on fourth down, that becomes a dead ball if anyone other than the fumbler himself recovers. So it'll come back to the spot of the fumble, and that will mean that's going to wind up being a turnover on downs. On first and 10, it's Herbert.
That's some space here.
Oh, that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line.
First down for the Bears, a gain of 15. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
Now a first down throw, Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 14 yards and a Chicago first down.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. Here we go. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Now it's Fields. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sack back at the 29. Marquise Bell from that outside linebacker spot gets in there. It's a loss of 9. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Santos' kick is up and through, and they take the lead here as it's now 9-6.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And you figure, Charles, they have enough time here in the first half, more than a minute, to put a drive together, at least get them in position to try a field goal.
Yeah, they've got all three timeouts at their disposal, so I'm at...
He's got him in! Complete! And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 33 yards that time.
And what great recognition between a receiver and his quarterback, because he's going to recognize the trouble, and then he has two options. Cut off the route and come back to help, or head straight down the field, and he chooses the latter, and it turns into a huge play.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. First down now, but that clock rolling. Now Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. From the red zone now, Prescott. Throw left side complete. That's Ferguson. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll bring up second down. Now Prescott. Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Two first half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Brandon Aubrey now for the extra point. And he bangs this one through to make it a 13-9 game now. So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. The Bears going to see the football first, and they trail here as we get back underway to start this second half. Sheds off the tackle. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
Well, Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
On second down, here's Fields. That is caught by Herbert. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 16 yards is the pickup there and a first down for Chicago. Herbert powering up the middle. And he's got this one across midfield in the Cowboy territory. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Here's Fields. He'll get that complete to Khalil Herbert. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 27-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. First down. Ready? Fields on first down. He'll buy some time right. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Equanimeous St. Brown, 27 yards. And the Bears have taken the lead here this third quarter. Bears offense staying put. Justin Fields always a threat to run. They'll go for 2 here. They're going to keep it on the ground. And he'll get into the end zone. So that pushes the lead up to 4. Well, after the touchdown, here's the punter Trenton Gill to kick it away. Fair catch going to be taken. And this will be moved out to the 25.
Thank you.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just all, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
Play action. Prescott out to his left. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Prescott to throw it. And he whips that one incomplete there. That right there, his first incompletion so far in this game, Charles. He was 9 of 9 before that.
Yeah, I think that qualifies as being locked in. And then you have to ask him the question. So what caused the incompletion? Come on, man. Get back on your game. Let's go.
On third down, it's Prescott.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Eddie Jackson picks it.
Now inside the 25.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And he maneuvers his way down to the three-yard line. He'll get six on the ground there, and it'll be second and goal coming up.
Hat tip to that offensive line. They're clearing some holes, even down here deep in the red zone. And that's a nice pickup on the ground on first and goal.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. Foreman. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action throw.
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago.
Khalil Herbert. It's a one-yard touchdown run. And the Bears will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third.
Santos able to tack on the extra point. And that pushes the lead up to 11.
Well, after the touchdown, here's the punter Trenton Gill to kick it away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
And they'll come up second and 7.
Pollard, he'll take it up the gut. Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Here's Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. Desperation time. Prescott on fourth. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
So this offense able to convert on fourth. And now a fresh set of downs here. First and 10.
Prescott off play action.
Man, open downfield is Gallup. He's got it. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. To throw is Prescott. And it's caught. Touchdown. Jake Ferguson, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Cowboys have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. They're going to try and run. And he will get into the end zone as a two-point conversion is successful. And the lead is down to a field goal here in the fourth. So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line. 2 yards on the pick.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Here's Fields. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there. And now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Here we go.
Five points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. And off running left, Foreman. And he is going to have the Bears first. And that should be the capper. Well, this ball game was close throughout. Remember, it was neck and neck at intermission, neck and neck at the end. But a great job to come in here in a tough environment, Charles, and get the victory.
Yeah, a tough environment indeed. How about all the people we can hear shouting from their seats right below?
Approaching manhood, peach fuzz covered my chin. Even then, I would leave rap, going with the wind. win. I'm not too good at following trends. I am the trend. I am the truth. I am the God. I am the Zen. There is no way around it. My just make amends. These flows are coated golden. If you the then I must be the cold and exploding with the commode is. Real soon they're gonna have dimension. Mr. Clay the magician with the greatest of Drizzy Drakes and Wheezy's, Andres and Jiggers, Pac, Biggie and Nas, Face Mob, Easy and Raekwon. It's easy to say these things looking for clout, but this is non-fiction. The proof's in the pudding, it's none missing. You and your opinion, you can stick that up your... I jumped to touch the sky and landed on planet Uranus. Houston, we got a problem. No need to look for solutions. I'm stacking Eisenhowers. Deceased presidents on the wall in my residence as I increase stepping on balling forever while kissing the sweet melanin of a broad that I met in the Netherlands. Address me as Marcus Clay, the developing veteran. That's why I got no time to sleep. I gotta creep the late night to get this cake to bake right. I'm thinking real estate licenses. I've seen multiple moments of indecisiveness. I got scars on my back that resemble tiger slits. When it's all said and done, I'll be one of the greatest, you know, the only one left, like a by the uno. But who knows what the future holds? My moving stupid. Most of you do it for the internet, and I'm not into that. And that's the disconnect. Comparing me to these rappers is disrespect. Who's the best MC? Cole, Kendrick, and me.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium.
Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the Baltimore Ravens.
Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone.
And he returns this to the 22.
Kevontae Turpin on the return. The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Play fake. Here's Prescott. And his first pass is incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Second and 10.
The first carry now for Tony Pollard. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. They find some open field here.
Touchdown, Cowboys. Brandon Cooks, 71 yards.
And the Cowboys are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore.
So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. Running room at the 50. Look out. He might score. He will score. Touchdown, Ravens. Well, go ahead and strap in, partner. Less than 2 minutes in, had the score on the one side. A quick answer, though, to get the equalizer.
Sometimes you get that sense of urgency that ratchets up, right? When you give up an early touchdown like that, you just know, you're like, okay, how do we go back and equalize things? Can we get it done fast? And they absolutely did. Essentially, we're back to even, aren't we?
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And his throw is going to be incomplete. And that is one, no doubt, that may come back to haunt them, because the PAT tighter, they didn't need to go for two.
I keep searching for an explanation. I know it's quick right here. I think I can search for the next year and not come up with anything that absolutely works. Kick the point, man. Kick the point. I don't get it.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. In Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. He finds his man, Pollard. And this one will be taken up. They'll spot it right at the 7. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now 4th down.
I think that call was made not so much to try and get the first down, although they would have taken it if they could have gotten it, but to give their punter a little bit of space and try and help out their defense.
Yeah, got the safe completion on 3rd. Now Prescott on 4th down. And he is caught. Now he's free at the 35. And all the way down to the 17-yard line. A real field flipper there, as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. 2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play. This is 2nd and 8. Prescott now. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Brandon Cooks. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Cowboys are able to widen their advantage. So Dak will bring the Cowboys up to go for the 2-point try. Dak's going to keep it. They'll try and run it here. And he will get into the end zone. And it's now a 2-score game as the lead moves to 9. They go with the option on the 2-point try, and the decision to pitch it worked out.
Almost felt like basketball, didn't it? But remember the dribbler, draw, drive, and dish? How about that one? Drew everyone to him, dished it to the running back. He takes it in.
And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. Ball
Baltimore with good starting field position as they come up first and 10 at their own 46. Jackson now. That's going deep for Bateman. Oh, his first throw of the game. Going to be intercepted. And the Cowboys are going to take possession here as they got it at their own four-yard line. Boy, that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open or lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
A pretty good-looking run there on first down. That'll go for 9 yards, just short of the line to gain. Play action now, Prescott. Throw complete right side to Colts. What a spin. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing, Prescott. He finds his man, complete. It's Ferguson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Cowboys in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Off the play fake, Prescott. And that's complete to Colts. Touchdown, Cowboys! Three touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott as his guys are able to extend their lead.
Well, just a sensational start for this offense, Charles. Three drives, three passing touchdowns.
Is that like mentioning a perfect game in baseball? Or are we cool to do it here in football, partner?
No, I think you can do it here in football. I think perfect game in baseball, that's its own category.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. Could not imagine a worse start for that secondary. Or let's face it, a better one for this offense. No chance they stop passing now the way that it's going. I think they're going to continue to press the ball downfield and hopefully reap the same results.
And he will get into the end zone to bump the lead up to 3 scores. So they kept it on the ground, got it into the end zone. But Charles, sometimes you probably see teams treat a two-point conversion differently than if it was first and goal from the two, or I should say third and goal from the two.
I agree with you totally on that. A lot of teams treat it as if they have farther to go and shy away from running the football. I think this is a great spot to do it because most teams play you for the pass. Go ahead and run and let your linemen surge and fire out.
And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Here's Jackson. And going deep for Hill. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50.
And Charles, you know, it seems like sometimes when you fall down early, there can be a tendency there to try and get it all back in one fell swoop. And that time, that thinking leads to an interception.
And I believe you brought up a really good point there, Brandon, because you try and force plays, right? You try and get all back in one shot, just as you mentioned there. And you know you're going to need some big plays to get back into the game. But ultimately, you really can't force what isn't there.
Prescott looks to throw on first. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dak Prescott now 4 touchdown passes on the afternoon. And the Cowboys continue to pull away here in this first half.
Now Mike McCarthy going to decide to go for two here.
They'll try and run it up the middle. And he is going to be stopped short of the goal line. Oh, they'll mark him inside the one. He just couldn't keep churning those extra few inches. And the two-point attempt is turned aside. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. What a second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Second down and three.
Now it's Jackson. Dumps it off to Edward. Now the ball comes loose. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And his guys will take over.
Count this money, then I count my blessings. If I ever took an L, then it's still for lesson. I'm the one, ain't no second guessing. World chain. Look, I built walls around the house, networking. All these bloodsuckers, I just hope it's networking. Soul searching, broken hearted with my chest hurting. But I was gifted with the best curses. I'm suffocating and my weight keep fluctuating. I show love, how the f*** you hating? Damn, I'm the greatest, but that's unrelated. I either overstay my welcome or I'm underrated. Lately, I've been trying to wake sleepers. The fake woke and the gatekeepers. Too shallow for big fish, I stay deeper. We all gotta meet the same reaper and the same maker, even if we never touch the same paper.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we are in Silicon Valley at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara.
Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Dallas Cowboys taking on the San Francisco 49ers.
And the 49er hands team does its job. Well, there's two sides to every coin. You come on the road, you get the onside kick to start the game. What a boost, but you don't get it. And now your back's against the wall a little bit.
You're exactly right. You nailed it perfectly. And so many ways to go at it when you're on the road. You think to yourself, well, if we start on defense, we blitz them early, try and create a big play. If we start on offense, we throw the big pass downfield. In this case, they said, forget all of that. Let's do it on special teams and try and catch them off guard with an onside kick unsuccessfully.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down.
Here's Samuel. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
Fourth down. 18 Cardinals, 18 Cardinals.
he fakes a spike. Flushed out right. Oh, what a read on the outside as it's intercepted. And the Cowboys are going to get the ball back on the turnover as they hold on fourth down. A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. Now Prescott. Cooks full extension. It's complete. Give them 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On play action, Prescott. They're looking for Lamb, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward, and he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
Partner, I think this one went awry very simply because he overestimated his arm strength and his ability to fit it anywhere he wants to. A lot of quarterbacks do that and often pay the price.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Open man is Juwan Jennings. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. Purdy now to throw. Steps away to his left. And he's got to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Brock Purdy, a 6-yard touchdown run.
And the 49ers use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Moody good with the extra point.
And that makes the score 7-0. So here's Moody back out there now to send this one away. Kevontae Turpin now from his end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Well, they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
Now a second and 10.
Now Prescott, rolling to his right. And he comes back with one complete. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. Prescott. Pollard here once again, back-to-back catches. And he will have a Cowboys
first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Prescott off play action. He's got his man on the crossing route. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw, Prescott. He'll fire one in zone for Cooks. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Tashawn Gibson. And the Niners are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
At their own 20-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. Now Purdy. He's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And they'll get 8 out of this before being stopped at the 28.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2 at the 28-yard line.
Throwing here, Purdy. Flush to his right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. How to approach this. Third down and 16 yards to go. Back to throw, Purdy. Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
And partner, I think this is where long-term starters in the NFL separate themselves from the rest of the pack, because there's still 3 full quarters left in this one. More than enough time to move past a pair of early mistakes and find a way to lead your team to a win. Mental resiliency, a characteristic every NFL team's looking for in their quarterback.
Cooks on a quick slant. Brandon Cooks, 32 yards. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from drawing level. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. 7-7, our score after one. And how about this decision? Tie game, first half, but here's an onside kick. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And the 49er hands team does its job. And that's why you have your hands team out there on the field. Those are the best guys ready to make that play.
And let's face it, it was executed well. It wasn't a bad kick. It wasn't anything like that, just that the normal outcome actually came to play. Analytics would tell you it's a very low possibility of getting the ball for the team kicking it in an onside kick situation.
You're all about the numbers, aren't
all
you?
All about the numbers, baby. It's a new game now.
They don't lie. Purdy. And that one too wide and incomplete.
I saw he thought he had an open work beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Here's 2nd and 10. Purdy off the play fake. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Marquise Bell. Came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage. 3rd and 19. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. Incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They'll go for it. Here's Purdy escaping the pressure right. Airs it out toward the corner of the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. And the Cowboys are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
Partner, have you ever heard the story of Icarus in mythology? That's the guy who flew too close to the sun and had his wings melted. That was our guy right there. Keeps pressing it and pressing it. Finally, on that throw, he paid the price with that turnover.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Play fake. Here's Prescott. And that'll be incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
So line of scrimmage still to 39 on second and 10. Play action now. Prescott sliding out of the pocket.
And that's complete downfield to Cooks.
Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 27 yards there, a first down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
First down throw for Prescott. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Andrew Thomas. And the 49ers are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
Still early in this one, Charles, but the last time this offense was out there, they threw their first interception of the ball game. So trying to avoid repeating that mistake here on this drive.
And to put a positive spin on it, at least it happened in the first half and not in a close game in the fourth quarter. But you're absolutely right, partner. One of the last things this offensive quarterback wants to witness again in this game.
Kind of an obvious question, Charles, but anything you try to avoid after your first pick, or you say it's one interception, we're still in the first half, I'm about to do the same thing?
I think you want to avoid playing scared, you know, and put it into the mind of the quarterback that you've lost confidence in him. Make sure you get some throws that he's going to be able to complete, make him feel good about himself, and continue to run your offense.
Third and 20. Here's Purdy. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Purdy to throw it on first down. Man open, that's Ray McCloud. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. First down now, but that clock rolling. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. And tip your cap to DeMarcus Lawrence. Nice play defensively. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to have the football at their own one-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Now the good news for them, they got the football. The bad news, they have to go 99 yards here as they start this drive out on their own one-yard line.
Now he gets free up the left sideline. He's got a full head of steam. Touchdown, Cowboys! Tony Pollard, 99 yards.
And the Cowboys will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half.
And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again, and again, and again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
And he will step out of bounds. Oh, what a mistake there. And the two-point try will be unsuccessful. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And the 49er hands team does its job. The risk reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want to blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out at Halloween, and you take what you want. They're having a blast out there playing against him today.
And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break.
With the score, Cowboys 13, 49ers 7.
And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And despite the turnovers, Charles, and they had multiple in that first half, they still have the lead as they begin this third quarter.
And they probably heard some conflicting tones at the half, don't you think? A lot of praise for what they did to get this lead, but also a little bit of scolding because they got to take better care of the football in the second half. But you and I both know the great leaders, they know how to give that little bit of vinegar in there and cover it with a big dose of honey.
Looking left sideline, it's complete. And now they're in the hurry-up. Off the play fake, Prescott. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. A second down throw for Prescott.
Swinging this out for Pollard.
And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10.
Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards down to the 10.
Ball sits on the 10, second and 5.
To throw is Prescott. And his throw here is going to be incomplete.
An open man that time, but end up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. And on third and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. On play action, Prescott. Touchdown, Cowboys! Brandon Cooks! his second touchdown of the night.
And the Cowboys take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
And he will dive into the end zone, and the two-point conversion is successful.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away.
The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
Great way, McLeod, on the return. The Niners take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
They make their second half debut here, and things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive.
And oh, my goodness, here's a fifth interception. Inside the 10, and he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
The extra point up and good by Aubrey,
and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Here's McLeod from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more.
Oh, an absolutely filthy juke. He's got some space now. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards. Purdy looking to throw on first down here. Flushed out right. Looking sideline, incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Second down, here's Purdy to throw.
Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there, and they're going to hurry back to the line now. Once more, Purdy looking to throw. Steps away. And now here is another interception. And the Cowboys are going to take over at their own 41. I know it appeared he was saying, hey, give me the football, I'm open, but I don't know if that's a pass that he should have thrown there.
Well, I don't think we've ever met a wide receiver that doesn't think he is open or is about to be open.
True.
So when you throw your hand up in the air and tell your quarterback, hey, I'm available, he's trusting that you are. In this case, he was not, and it turned into disaster for them.
And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. Prescott now on second down. They'll roll him out right. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line.
Here now a third down and eight.
Start with Pollard. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of nine on first down.
Just need a yard here. Second and one.
Prescott now. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Prescott off play action. Side, it's complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 23 yards on the play.
I know we just saw a nice throw and catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 34. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And the result here, a pickup of eight. Leaves him with two to go on second down. Now Prescott. He finds his man, Pollard. Touchdown! Tony Pollard, 25 yards for the touchdown.
And the Cowboys put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Well, forget about the weapons out wide. He knows he's got another weapon in the backfield of the passing game, Charles, and he utilized him perfectly on that play.
And the offense coordinator showed me something on that play, Brandon, because so often during a game, our cameras find them looking down at their play sheets, and you wonder if they're absorbing anything. He had something specific in mind, and he went to it, and it worked well.
They're going to keep it on the ground, and he will get in to make it 8-0.
So what do you make of that? You go on the road, you score the opening drive touchdown, opt to go for two, and all of a sudden they're up 8-0.
Yeah, this wasn't a decision that they made right here and right now. They made this decision during the week. Hey, if we get the ball and score right away, let's show them that we feel like we're superior, go for two, and really put the pressure on them.
So after the touchdown, Aubrey now to kick this one away. And this is fielded just short of the goal line, but the fair catch means this drive will begin at the 25. Tagovailoa and the Dolphins come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll run here with Raheem Mostert, and he'll get this up just shy of the 30.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second down. Here's Mostert again. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 13 and a Dolphin first down. Veteran running back like him, we've seen a lot of those chunk carries in his career.
And that's why you don't just look at his birth certificate and decide when a guy is done, right? Because you know as well as I do, in this league, as soon as you hit 30, they're looking to let you go if you're a running back. Sometimes a little tread left on the tires.
So the completion good for 7 there, and it'll be second down. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. A rifle's one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. Still going inside the 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Well, mistake there by the offense, Charles. They tried to pick on a Pro Bowl corner in coverage there, and not the smartest decision. He reminded him that he was a Pro Bowl corner with not only the pick, but the pick six.
And those guys who have that designation, sometimes they get a little bit bored in games because people try to avoid them. They absolutely love it when they get challenged, and it's a chance to remind everyone exactly why they were tapped as one of the best in the league the prior season.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25.
All right, come on.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go-around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to return.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss.
It's a loss of two.
Tua sets up to pass it. And the pressure gets there, and Tua's going to be taken down. Micah Parsons showing off that elite athleticism as he gets the sack. Not the start to this one that any quarterback would want or envision. Remember, he had the pick six, and here he ends up on his backside.
And you have to wonder to yourself, okay, after throwing the pick six, did he get too careful with the football and not deliver downfield and take that sack? They've got to make sure that he's really into this game.
That ball caught. It's Joseph. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. On first down, Tagovailoa. He's going to drop this underneath to Mostert.
Flash the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35.
A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5 at the Cowboys' 37-yard line.
They'll swing this complete out to Hill. And Hill is going to have a Dolphins first down as he'll get this down to the 30-yard line.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard.
From the 20, here's 2nd and a yard.
Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Wide open receiver complete.
And the Dolphins are going to have a 1st and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line.
1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's 2nd and goal. Now Tua. Quick hitter here, it's complete. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's 3rd and goal. Tua gonna throw. Now he's got it. They're able to hold him to 3 there, and that leads to a 4th and goal.
A gain of 3 yards brings up.
They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. An incompletion there on 4th and goal from the 3. And this Cowboy defense comes up with a goal line stand. Prescott on 1st down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
On 2nd down, it's Pollard. Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. So a free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away.
And this returnable for Hill.
And he'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up past the 40-yard line.
Now that's the kind of return you're looking for. To get to that spot on the field, that allows you to do a lot of things on offense.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They've got some stuff to build on from that last drive because they moved the football, CD, and then they tried to go for it on 4th down, didn't convert, probably left a bitter taste in their mouths.
I would say so, and I think that they go out in this series determined for that not to happen again. In fact, they don't want to get to a 4th down opportunity. They just want to make sure they get it done within the parameters that they've set for themselves. Run their offense, get it into the end zone. Yeah, I think a little bit of determination and a dash of anger.
Midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Tua now on 1st down. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. 2 to throw again. And they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And he gets this inside the 10 to the 9. It's also a gain of 9.
2 are going to try and go quickly here.
On 2nd down, Mostert. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on 3rd down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the 1st down. 3rd and 1, and Tua wants to throw it. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And the Dolphins are going to have a 1st and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on 3rd and 1.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Raheem Mostert from 3 yards out. And the Dolphins get a late score here in the final minute of the 1st half.
Tua going to try and throw for it.
Completed the run. And he is not going to get in here. So the decision to go for two does not pay off as they're unable to cut any further into their deficit. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown.
And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Certainly not the way they drew it up in the playbook, but that's why they love this guy back there. He sees things breaking down, and he's more than capable of finding an escape route and still getting a decent gain.
Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Play action's supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Off the play fake, Prescott eluding the pressure right.
And off-balance throw there, and it's going to wind up incomplete.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And he's going to be out of bounds inside the 25-yard line.
A big connection on that one. 41 yards. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. And his kick is right there. It's good, and that will do it for this first half. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL. On EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
The Dolphins take over first and 10.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive.
This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. Tua once again here on second and 10. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. They'll try and lay this out for Chosen. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs. And the Cowboys are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
Well, I certainly think that we're seeing a big reason why this team has struggled to put points on the board so far, because too many of their drives have ended in turnovers already, and we still have almost a full half of football yet to play.
A throw left side to start out. That's complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Play fake. Here's Prescott. Pass the 20. And they move this all the way down to the 9. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. On play action, Prescott. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. The first down went in the wrong direction. They're at the 13-yard line. Here's second and goal. Throwing, Prescott. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. Looking to throw, Prescott. They'll start this drive out on the ground. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
From the 33, here's a second and four. Play action now, Prescott.
A short one there, taken in by Ferguson. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Prescott on play action. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. Oh, he breaks a tackle and he's got an alley. And he'll go down to Bonifor getting this inside the 30. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Prescott to throw it. He's got a man. That's caught. Left sideline. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door. First and goal. They'll run with Pollard. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's second and goal. Back to the 8-yard line now. Prescott down. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Ferguson. They get only a yard there. Now it's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory? Might he go for it?
And oh, it'll be intercepted.
Picked off by Cameron Curl. And the Commanders are going to have the football at their own 1-yard line.
Not something you see very often from a quarterback of his caliber, an opening drive interception.
Oh, there's no doubt in my mind that even he's surprised at how that one played out. But we know this guy. It's not going to stop him from continuing to fire as this game goes along. Probably give a little nod of respect across the field for that one and let him know he'll be back the very next series.
First carry here for Robinson. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line.
But both teams practice this situation. And this time, the guys on offense won, and in a very nice way. What a run from that position on their own goal line.
Gave them some good breathing room.
I wonder now, do you still stack the line of scrimmage, or do you play normal defense? They may have backed them off with that run.
On second down, another shot for Robinson.
And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage.
Third and three.